Okay, I'm going to solve this problem that I have up here. It says I need to construct a truth table for the compound proposition if P or Q, then P and Q. And I've already sketched out what my truth table is going to look like, and we'll just fill in the truth values of that truth table. So this conditional is a compound conditional, and the only values that we the component values, the sort of atomic values that we have to worry about, are contained in the propositions P and Q. Okay, so what I've done is I've written those as my column first, P and Q, and I've split up the truth values in such a way so that it's easy for me not to forget one. And this is kind of the way everybody does it. So I did true, true, false, false for P, and then true, false for Q. And I have all four combinations, or rather permutations, of P and Q's truth values here. So the first thing I need to do is figure out the truth value of P or Q. And it turns out that you have to know that already or be able to intuit that. Most people memorize, if you have to, the truth table for P or Q when you're first learning about this sort of stuff. But it turns out I've written under useful stuff. I've written the truth value just in words because it's that easy. I could have written on the truth value, or the truth table. But P or Q is false when both are false and is true otherwise. Okay, so when P and Q are both false, then I have that P or Q is false. So that's this case right here. P is false, Q is false, and then it's true otherwise. That sort of makes sense if you think about the definition of P or Q happening, but I won't get into that now. The same thing about P and Q, it's very intuitive, but I've written out the statement about the truth value of P and Q based on the truth values of P and Q individually. So it turns out that P and Q is true when both P and Q are true and is false otherwise. So P and Q are true, that's here. P is true and Q is true. And it's going to be false otherwise. And this is basic stuff you have to know in order to do these bigger problems. It just has to come naturally, or you have to memorize, as I said, the truth table to start. Now we get to the meat of this problem, and that is the compound proposition itself. Now notice though, I've broken the compound proposition up into every little component that you can sort of think through in order to make this an easy transition from these two columns to the last column. I have a lot of students who will, on a test, they won't put these two in there, the intermediate steps, and they end up kind of getting lost and try to keep too much in their heads and mess up over here what is normally a pretty easy problem for everybody. So now I have to figure out what happens if I have a conditional. If let's say A, then B. When, for those truth values, it just turns out that that this A is something more than just a traditional proposition, as a compound proposition itself. So we got to figure out what happens in a conditional based on the truth values of the hypothesis and the conclusion, P and Q, respectively, in this particular truth table. So it turns out that when you have if P then Q, the only time that that conditional is false is when the hypothesis is true and the conclusion is false. So over here, I have the hypothesis and the conclusion already laid out, and it occurs twice in our problem here, that the hypothesis, which is this guy right here, P or Q, is true, and the conclusion, P and Q, is false. So that's my only time that I have to worry about getting a false when I have a conditional. The other two are going to be true. And there you have it. It was that easy. I've constructed a truth table for this compound proposition.